members' property ownership interests.
Okay, Mr. Dufault, the HOA will be admitted as party.
Thank you.
I am Nick Falls from Westminster Presbyterian Church. I'm the clerk of session. Obviously, we're in the northeast corner of the Crayberry Farm. So we will be impacted by the road.
Mr. McFalls, what's the address of the church?
10 West Pleasant Grove Road.
Are you here asking for party status for the church itself?
On behalf of the church, yes.
Okay, has the church authorized you to do so?
There has not been a specific resolution, no. I'm the clerk of the governing board of the session.
Mr. Allen?
I have a conditional objection. We need authorization in order to make sure you're the only one speaking on behalf of the church. Otherwise, we face the prospect of multiple church members showing up during the meetings. To the extent that an authorization is provided by the church, we don't have an objection to the church's standing.
Mr. McFalls, is that something you think you can obtain in time for the next hearing?
Yes, we can.
Okay, so we'll conditionally accept you as a party. Remind me, and we'll make sure we get that for the next hearing. Thank you. Yes, ma'am, your name, please.
Suzanne Lauer. I'm here on behalf of the Quarry Swimming Association.
Could you spell that, please? The association.
Quarry, Quarry, Swimming, Swimming, Association.
Where is that located, please?
1146 South New Street.
Is the association a corporation?
It's an association.
Member
owned and operated.
Did the association authorize you to be here to speak on its behalf?
Yes.
Did you submit a party status form?
All right.
Let the record reflect that you're doing so now. Is the authorization in writing from the association included with that?
No.
Did the association receive the notice in the mail?
Yes, they did. It's attached.
Mr. Edelman?
Similar objection on the conditional receipt of authorization. I do have one question, though, ma'am. Does the association own the property, or is it owned by a different entity?
No, they own the property.
Okay. And do you know whether, and I think Mr. McKenna may have asked this, is the association a nonprofit corporation in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania?
I don't know if we legally have that status, but we are a nonprofit.
So just the same objection based upon receipt of authorization, authorizing.
So you want written authorization?
Yes, so that you're here to speak on their behalf as the authorized representative.
Okay.
So we'll conditionally admit you as a party for this evening and then ask that you bring that writing at the next hearing in March.
All right.
Thank you. Yes, sir, your name?
Leonard Memucari, 523 West Pleasant Grove Road, West End.
Sir, can you spell your last name for me, please?
Pardon me?
Can you spell your last name for me, please?
M-A-M-M-U-C-A-R-I.
Did you receive a copy of the notice in the mail?
Say again, sir.
Did you receive a copy of the notice in the mail?
I'm not sure, but I have a copy today.
Well, is that your party status form, or is that the notice that you received?
Party status form here.
Okay, if you wouldn't mind handing that to my assistant.
Sorry, sir. Please don't go yet.
Wait, sir, we're not done yet.
Going back.
A couple more questions. What was the address on the parcel again, please?
523 West Pleasant Grove Road.
Do you own that property, sir?
In conjunction with my daughter, yes.
Mr. Edelman?
Sir, can you just do me a favor and indicate where your property is located on that aerial, Exhibit A0? If you could walk over to it and just point it out for me, please. Great. All right, no objection. Thank you.
Sir, you'll be admitted as a party. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there anyone else who received a copy of the notice or whose parties received a copy of the notice in the mail? Mr. Thompson.
Mr. McKenna, my name is Mark Thompson. I'm an attorney with the firm of Land McElwain, and I represent Neighbors for Crevely LLC, which is a limited liability corporation formed to advocate on behalf of neighbors which have joined that organization. Two of the neighbors received the notices, members of Neighbors for Crevely LLC. So I have 29 individual forms of our members. I have an individual form on behalf of this organization, Neighbors for Crevely. I also have a Department of State printout indicating that it is a viable LLC.
Do you know who the managing member is of the LLC?
Yes, it's Vincent Moro. He's the president.
Can you spell the last name for me?
M-O-R-O.
Which of the members, if you know, received notice for the hearing?
The first members are Kathleen Turner and David Turner. They live at 116 Spur Lane, which is directly across Route 926. They can see the property from their house. The other member is Marilyn Powell, 1057 East Niels Lane. Mrs. Powell's here tonight, Mr. Ailey, if you care to ask her any questions. We also have a member that lives on Dunvegan, Myron and Sharon Grumbaugh.
Can you spell the last name for me, please?
G-R-U-B-A-U-G-H. But as you know, an organization such as this draws its standing from its individual members, and all we need to show is that we have individual members that are affected by the application.
Mr. Ailey?
Why don't we start with the three members that you're claiming are affected directly, immediately, and substantially by the application. Are the first members you cited, Kathleen and Donald, I can't remember, was it Turner here present?
Did not see them.
Okay, then I object on the basis that they're not here in order to put facts into the record with respect to how they may be agreed. Can we ask, is it Ms. Powell?
Yes.
To come forward, please.
I live in East Niels Lane, which, if you look from the side of my home, you can see West Pleasant Grove Road. And I've lived there for many, many years. But my question, I have a couple questions, but one is a lot of the traffic. What's going to happen? It's going to be horrendous. It's bad now, because I use it to go to my work. Secondly, there are things like, a lot of us have just put in new septic systems, and are we going to have to now, because they all have sewers, so we have to go ahead and do that. And the same way with the water situation, well, we have to hook up and do that too. All the people in our development are concerned. So some of them, the newer homes, which are at least 50 years old, do have a sewer. not sewer, sorry, water, because they were told before the builder built those homes that they had to do that.
Ms.
But other than us, we've been fine, we haven't had any problems.
Ms. Powell, and I'm going to interrupt, but I think Mr. Hillman might want to ask you a couple of questions real quick, okay?
No, that's sufficient. I don't have an objection to Ms. Powell's individual standing.
Well, I don't think he's seeking it from Ms. Powell. He's seeking it as a member of the LLC, as basically one of the clients.
That's why I'm not objecting to her individual standing. I haven't finished. He's offered three members. I was going to withhold my objection to the entity as a whole. I have some questions for Mr. Thompson with respect to the entity as a whole.
Fair enough. So are you done with Ms. Powell?
Yes, I am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
I'm sorry to hear.
He has no further questions for you.
Thank you, ma'am. I appreciate that. And then the last individuals that you said with Myron and...
Myron Broombaugh.
Yes, are they here?
We live at the corner of Dunhagen and John Anthony. We're approximately 1,800 feet from the property. We can show you where
Please.
We are if you would like us to.
Please, thank you. Okay, thank you. Can you please tell me how you are aggrieved by this application?
With the way the roads are going to be set up, the intersection into the development of Craven at Dunhagen, that's going to be used as a cut-through, and it's going to drastically increase traffic on a fairly quiet and nice subdivision road. It's going to be backed up. It's backed up at New Street and Pleasant Grove in the evening and morning, and people are going to be cutting through there to make a right to go up to New Street. So we're going to have increased traffic. We're going to have increased taxes due to sewer costs, road costs, upkeep, trash, whatever you want to call it. Anything that's going to be have to be paid by the township, there's going to be increased costs there. We're going to lose a revered, hallowed, historical battleground that apparently not a whole lot was known about until about 10 years ago, and there have been new findings that show that there were battles, skirmishes fought on Cray Billy. And we're just going to lose a lot of quality of life that subdivision has that we've enjoyed for 17 years.
Can I get your exact property address, please?
1024 Dunvegan, Dunvegan Road, Westchester.
All right. Again, I don't have an objection to their individual standing, Mr. Cameron. And I'd like to ask Mr. Thompson some questions with respect to the entity as a whole.
Thank you, sir. You are done.
Thank you.
Mr. Edelman?
Good evening, Mr. Thompson. How are you? Does the Neighbors for Cray Billy actually own any physical property within the vicinity of the Cray Billy Farm?
The association does not. Its members do.
What is the organizational purpose as espoused in the operating agreement or formation documents for the Neighbors for Cray Billy LLC?
To advocate on behalf of individuals in favor of responsible development of Cray Billy Farm.
Could I see that on a piece of paper?
I don't have that with me.
Would it be in the LLC operating agreement?
Yes, it would be. I don't have that here tonight.
One second.
I don't believe I'm required to prove the existence of the LLC beyond the fact that it does exist under the Department of State.
I'm not going to object to the formation of the LLC. My objection on the record is that while the individual members have testified with respect to traffic, if the organizational purpose of the LLC is different, I don't believe the members' individual property ownership interest can give the LLC standing. So I need to be able to ascertain the organizational purpose as a matter of fact, not just conjecture, hearsay.
We can certainly provide the operating agreement as part of the record, but as Mr. McKenna knows, the standing of an organization is derived from its individual members. So All we need to show is that we have one individual member that is particularly affected by this application to give the entire organization standing.
And I disagree with your assertion of the law. The standing can only be derived if the purpose of the organization is in concert with the interests that are affected by the individual property owners. So that's why I need to confirm what you're saying is true with respect to the LLC's purpose.
All right, Mr. Edelman, may I suggest that you would have an objection at this point, pending perhaps Mr. Thompson providing you with the operating agreement?
It would be the same conditional based on the other aspects of the church and the, I can't remember, the swim club as well, but they have to be consistent and in accordance with the law.
Well, are you seeking a written authorization from the LLC as well?
Well, who is the authorized representative? You are, Mr. Thompson.
I am the authorized representative.
Yeah, I don't need one for a lawyer who's representing an LLC. But I definitely need to see the documents to make sure that the organizational purpose is in concert with the members that the organization is claiming that they derive their standing from.
Okay, so what we'll do is we'll treat the LLC as if it's a party for this evening. Mr. Thompson, if you're so inclined and you wish to produce the documentation to Mr. Edelman, it may resolve itself and he may stipulate by the time of March's meeting. If not, the board will render a decision.
That's fine. I have individual applications for party status from 29 members as well as an application from the organization. I presume you want me to submit that to
that. Hang on, Mr. Edelman. Yes, but I have a question for you. Are you seeking party status for them as individuals or as members of the LLC?
Only as individuals listing their names as a member of the LLC.
Okay.
I don't have an objection pending the resolution of my prior objection. However, I just want to confirm that I'm not going to have 29 members showing up saying things on behalf of the LLC in terms of testimony or any evidence.
I can't prevent individuals from showing up to do anything, but I can tell you that I'm the only one that's going to be presenting any testimony on behalf of the LLC.
That's fair enough. They certainly can make public comment. I wasn't alluding to the fact that that would be restricted. I was just alluding to the fact that there would be one representative of the organization during the proceedings.
Okay.
All right, yes, if you wouldn't mind.
Submit those forms.
That's fine. If you wouldn't mind handing the forms over to my assistant, she'll take them for you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson. Anyone else, property owners within 500 feet, you received notice seeking party status this evening? Ms. Laborum, I'm well familiar with who you are, but if you wouldn't mind just introducing yourself to Mr. Edelman and to the public.
I'm sorry. My name is Kathleen Laborum, Supreme Court ID number 36280.
Mr. Edelman, Ms. Laborum is here representing Thornbury Township. Any objection for party status for Thornbury?
Good evening, Kathy. How are you? I don't have an objection so long as the township is entering its appearance with respect to just the connector road and any impacts from the connector road and the signal. If it's limited on that basis, I have no objection to
their
standing.
It's not limited on that basis. It is limited to traffic and the effects of traffic, and we'll be hoping to present evidence on traffic calming and traffic patterns.
Will Thornbury Township be presenting any evidence with respect to the intersection at 926 and 202?
Yes.
Okay. No objection.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Laborum. Thornbury Township will be admitted as a party.
I own Gavaletta's Seafood Market. I leased the property.
Hang on. Do me a favor. Put the microphone right up in your mouth there.
Sorry about
That's
that.
Okay.
A little tall.
Your name?
Andy Gavaletta. I own Gavaletta's Seafood Market in the West Town Village. Directly across the street.
Give me 1 second, sir. Did you, you did not receive a copy of the notice in the mail?
I did not. My landlord received a copy.
Okay. What's the address of your business?
1193 Wilmington Pike.
Who is the landlord?
The person or the company?
The company's fine.
Silver Star.
You're not here on behalf of the landlord. You're here on behalf of your company.
My company.
You're a tenant in the property located at 1193 Wilmington Pike?
Correct.
You're currently there under an existing lease?
Correct.
How long have you been at that location?
I signed the lease in July.
Of 2016?
Correct.
All right, sir, can you explain to the board why you're seeking party status and how your business, I guess, would be affected?
Well, I own Gattaloa Seafood. I have a note on my house, so I'm neither for nor against right now, but if something arises, I would like to have a say. I guess this is the meeting that can do that. So that's why I'm speaking on.
Thank you, sir.
Traffic is an issue, so that's what I would go under is traffic.
Mr. Anlin?
If you could expound on that, please, sir. How would traffic impact your tenant rights at the shopping center?
Tenant right as a business, I'm just worried about the traffic. So I'm not, at the end of the day, it would probably help me, but I'm worried about the traffic. So I don't want to have traffic issues and have my customers complain. So I'm just here to make sure if there is a development that is made,